Hi guys, we'll see generic classes in Java. Now as we can have generic method, even I can have whole class as a generic class. Generally if data structures are there, then they are implemented as generic classes, like you know the linked list. So linked list is a data structure which can hold elements like integer, float, double, and those elements are stored discretely. They are not, you know, they are not on continuous memory, they are stored inside some discrete memory blocks. So what is the advantage of implementing them as generic classes? I need not to implement same algorithm again and again. So if I want to insert one element into linked list, then the steps will be same. I need to disconnect few references and I need to reset few references, so that all after insertion all the nodes of the linked list are in proper way. So that algorithm or that sequence of instructions of that sequence of execution of instructions will be same. Only thing is I need to execute it for different types. So in that case I will go for generic classes. The declaration syntax for generic classes is same as that of generic method. In generic method we write the generic type in angular brackets before the return type of the method. Here also we write that generic parameter, but we write it after the class name. So here one class is shown, which is box class, which is implemented as generic class. It has methods add and get. The return type of get method is t, which is generic type, and add method argument is t. So I can call the I can create the object of box class, and I can call these methods with some specific types from the main method. So let me implement this example practically.
In this program we will see how to write a generic class. Example of box class is given. It can be declared as generic class by writing generic type t in angular brackets after the class name. Now this class has one member which is of generic type t. Then add method is there, which is adding value to that instance variable or member, and get method is there, which is retrieving the value of the member. In main method I am creating two objects of box class, one for integer, other for string, using default constructor. After that I call add method for each object, and I am adding the corresponding type. Here I am adding integer and here I am adding string. And then by calling get method, I am also retrieving the value which is there in the data member, and I am printing that value. So if I run this code, it will print both the values that I have passed, 10 and hello world. So these data types can be changed depending on requirement. So this is how we implement generic class in Java.